the science behind plant parenting, cultivating a green thumb with knowledge. Hello friends, welcome to Gardener's Gardening. Plant parenting, the nurturing care of houseplants, has become a popular trend in recent years. It's more than just a hobby, it's a practice that combines elements of biology, ecology, and psychology. Understanding the science behind plant parenting can help even the most novice plant enthusiast grow thriving, vibrant plants. Let's delve into the science that underpins this green thumb pursuit. Number 1. Photosynthesis, the lifeblood of plants. At the heart of plant care is photosynthesis, the process by which plants convert light energy into chemical energy. During photosynthesis, plants absorb sunlight through chlorophyll in their leaves and use it to convert carbon dioxide and water into glucose and oxygen. This glucose fuels the plant's growth, while oxygen is released as a byproduct. Key points for plant parents. Light requirements. Different plants have varying light needs. Some thrive in bright, direct sunlight, like succulents, while others prefer indirect or low light, like ferns. Understanding your plant's light requirements is crucial for healthy growth. Artificial lighting. In environments with insufficient natural light, artificial grow lights can supplement a plant's light needs, ensuring they receive the right spectrum for photosynthesis. Number 2. Watering, striking the right balance. Water is essential for plants, not only for photosynthesis, but also for nutrient transport, temperature regulation, and maintaining cell structure. However, overwatering or underwatering can be detrimental. Key points for plant parents. Soil moisture. The soil acts as a reservoir for water. Different plants have different soil moisture preferences. Cacti and succulents prefer dry soil, while tropical plants like moisture-retentive soils. Root health. Overwatering can lead to root rot, a condition where the plant's roots are deprived of oxygen, leading to decay. Conversely, underwatering can cause dehydration and wilting. Understanding your plant's water needs and checking soil moisture before watering are critical. Number 3. Nutrient uptake, feeding your plants. Plants require a range of nutrients to grow, most of which they absorb through their roots. The primary macronutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, often represented as the NPK ratio on fertilizer labels. Key points for plant parents. Fertilization. Regular fertilization can provide the essential nutrients that might be lacking in potting soil. However, over-fertilization can lead to nutrient burn, harming the plant. A balanced approach, considering the specific needs of the plant and the growing season, is essential. Soil composition. The type of soil used can significantly impact nutrient availability. For example, well-draining soil is critical for plants like succulents, while rich loamy soil benefits heavy feeders like tomatoes. Number 4. Environmental factors, creating the ideal microclimate. Plants are sensitive to their environment. Factors such as temperature, humidity, and air circulation play a significant role in their health and growth. Key points for plant parents. Temperature. Most houseplants thrive in temperatures between 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit or 15 to 24 degrees Celsius. Sudden temperature fluctuations, drafts, or placement near heating vents can stress plants. Humidity. Many houseplants, especially tropical varieties, prefer higher humidity levels. In dry indoor environments, using a humidifier or placing plants on a pebble tray with water can help maintain the right humidity. Air circulation. Good air circulation helps prevent the buildup of moisture on leaves, reducing the risk of fungal diseases. Placing plants in well-ventilated areas can help keep them healthy. Number 5. pruning and propagation, encouraging growth and new life. Pruning helps manage a plant's size, shape, and health by removing dead or overgrown parts. Propagation, the process of growing new plants from cuttings, is not only a way to expand your plant collection, but also a fascinating insight into plant biology. Key points for plant parents. Pruning techniques. Regular pruning encourages new growth and prevents plants from becoming leggy. It's also a way to remove diseased or damaged parts, which can otherwise spread to healthy tissue. Propagation methods. Depending on the plant, propagation can be done through stem cuttings, leaf cuttings, or division. Understanding the specific propagation method for your plant type can lead to successful new plant growth. Number 6. The psychological benefits of plant parenting. Beyond the biological aspects, plant parenting has been shown to have significant psychological benefits. Caring for plants can reduce stress, increase feelings of well-being, and even improve focus and productivity. Key points for plant parents. Mindfulness. Tending to plants encourages mindfulness, a practice linked to reduced anxiety and improved mood. The act of watering, pruning, or simply observing your plants can serve as a calming, meditative practice. Connection to nature. In urban environments, indoor gardening provides a vital connection to nature, promoting a sense of tranquility and grounding. Plant parenting is both an art and a science. By understanding the biological needs of your plants and creating an optimal environment, you can cultivate a thriving indoor garden. Moreover, the process offers a rewarding experience that extends beyond the greenery, fostering a deeper connection to the natural world and enhancing mental well-being. Whether you're a seasoned plant parent or just starting, embracing the science behind plant care will undoubtedly lead to a more fulfilling and successful plant parenting journey. If you found this video useful, make sure to hit the like button, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe to the channel to catch all our future updates. Take good care of your plants and keep them thriving. Thanks for watching, and God bless.